Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to some NHL 15 action here in the way of a brand new series I'm going to start up. I've had this one planned since I saw the first footage of NHL 15 and since a certain player was added to my hometown Minnesota Wild roster, Thomas Vanek, coming to join this roster, coming home sort of, as he played at the University of Minnesota. And that kind of got me fired up when he signed as a free agent here to this Minnesota Wild roster, already featuring Zach Parise and Ryan Suter, Mikko Koivu. You keep going on and on here, Granlund. So I wanted to get back to my roots, get back to controlling my hometown Minnesota Wild in be a GM mode. Now, the mode has been stripped down a little bit here for next gen. There are some issues. Yes, people have said you can't even draft players when it comes to the end of the year. That is done for you automatically. You control the scouting in here, what you're going to try to scout throughout the season, but apparently the draft is done for you. So, you know, there's a little bit of an issue about what we can actually do as a GM. Obviously, you can make moves, make trades. I like this roster how it is. Obviously, we will make some moves as we go, whatever we see that fits accordingly. But this team is not a rebuild right now. This team is hopefully a team that I can guide into the playoffs and try to go after that elusive Stanley Cup. Yep, got to bring one to Minnesota here. The North Stars came close on a couple occasions, got to the Stanley Cup Finals, but lost on both occasions. Now the Minnesota Wild, who have made one appearance in the Western Conference Finals, and that was early on in their existence, looking to get back there and beyond. So I'm not going to promise anything like that, but we're going to obviously have high hopes coming into the season now that Vanek's on the roster, and we should have a decent team going into the season. The problem is we play in the Central Division with a couple other really good teams, the Chicago Blackhawks, the St. Louis Blues. It's tough around here. Last year in real life, the Wild made it in the playoffs as a 7 seed. They had to be one of those two wildcard teams because there was no way they were catching either Chicago or St. Louis. And that's just how stiff the competition is. Were they in some conferences or some divisions in the Eastern Conference, they would have been one of those top two teams. But that's just what they've got to deal with the realignment here. It's nice to get back against more natural rivals like Chicago and St. Louis, instead of constantly jumping time zones and playing the Calgarys and Vancouvers of the NHL. So this is pretty cool. Just kind of going through what will be expiring contracts after the season. We've got some work to do as there are some unrestricted and restricted free agents, a whole boatload of them actually, at the end of this season. So we're going to have to definitely look at this, see what we can deal with under the salary cap, see if there are people elsewhere that'll help at the end of the year as well. But for this year, we're set. It's just, this is what we got to keep in mind as the season winds down. Who of these guys are we going to work to re-sign? Who can we afford to re-sign and stay under those cap numbers? So that is just a outlook on the franchise right here and what we have to deal with as far as contracts. If you guys want to let me know who you think is worth keeping and who you think I could let walk at the end of the season, I can definitely take those suggestions in the comment section below. I know it's going to be a while till we deal with a lot of that, but we're getting ready to sim up to the opener, and now you see the salary cap is set for the following season. It'll be at $69 million. The minimum cap is at $51 million. Okay, here are my lines starting out. You got the big top line of Parise, Koivu, and Vanek. I'm not sure if that's how they're going to play it or not. You got Nino Niederreiter, Granlund, and Pominville on that second line. Looking like we're ready to roll. We're taking on the Colorado Avalanche for the season opener and the home opener here. Just about time to throw it out to XL Energy Center. Let's go.
It's called the State of Hockey, Minnesota. The nights are cold, the winters are long, and the action is terrific. Tonight is another night of hockey in St. Paul for the Minnesota Wild. Greetings, everyone, along with Eddie Olchek, Mike Emmerich, right before game time here. It's an interesting sport in that sometimes your star players only play a third of the time. Do they ever make a contribution, though?
Well, you need them, Doc, to make those big contributions. Star players are a real important cog to the success of your team, because if you don't have a lot of them, you're not going to have much success. Suter's versatility, Doc, is what makes him a special player. Look for him to be front and center throughout this game.
Let's look at the starting netminders. Backstrom's in goal tonight. The coach's decision made with confidence for the Wild. Semyon Varlamov, a world traveler, has played for the Hershey Bears, the Washington Capitals, Colorado Avalanche, overseas, a part of the rejuvenation of the Avs, and represented his native Russia in the Olympics. Another terrific night of hockey here.
Okay, as they say at XL Energy Center before every game, it's time to drop the puck. Let's play hockey, and we are underway here in the first period. The Wild coming out buzzing in front of their home crowd. Suter, who was featured in the pregame, gets a shot on net there, but Varlamov makes the save. Not a real problem right there. Here's a shot that's going to be blocked from the point. Working this puck around, though, here. We want to have good movement here. That's Granlund to Pominville behind the net. Niederreiter gets a backhand chance and can't get it to go, but a lot of action in front of the net here, swarming around, just throwing every loose puck at the net and hoping for rebounds. Now behind the net again, out front, and another save, a rebound chance. No, it will not go. Varlamov standing tall. Here's Erik Haula with a chance. That's going to be stopped. Rebound. He's got it behind the net. Comes around and wheels and fires. That's saved, and another save. Varlamov turning the Wild away in this first period, despite them very much controlling play. And we go into the second here now. Power play for the Avs, and a shot on net. Backstrom makes that save. Cannot clear. He finds that and skates. A nice pass and a goal! Colorado gets on the board first. So there you go. All that pressure for the Wild. But it is the Avs who get the first goal of the game. We got a couple happy fans in the crowd there as Landeskog gets the goal. Nino Niederreiter not very happy, as he was the one in the box. As you see, they struggled to keep that in, but he just does keep that in. And the scramble for the puck, the Wild kind of lose control of their man. And that's Landeskog in front getting the tip. Very nice job there as he redirects that one in for a goal. 1-0 Colorado, but they're not done. Here they are charging the net again. This is going to be a shot that's wide, but look at this. Backstrom and company cannot find the rebound, and it is put home by the Avalanche. That was not pretty at all, and that's really unfortunate. That ends up in the back of the net, but Patrick Bortolo gets this goal. Garbage goal, if you will. Look at him just scrumming right there. Puck is loose that entire time. Backstrom can't find it to cover it, and it ends up being an easy Avalanche goal and a 2-0 lead. Very unfortunate right there. Now we have a 2-goal deficit to dig out from. Have to see what we can do here in the third period early on. A race to the puck won by Koivu. He's going to come up front, take that shot. Nice save by Varlamov, just like all the others. But in front, he's still going to work. There's Koivu digging away, and he gets a goal. He's able to redirect that one, I think, on the backhand. While they're on the board, and XL Energy erupts for the first time this season, they get to celebrate a goal. So now we've got most of the third period to make our charge here. That is Mikko Koivu's first from Vanek, and it is 2-1. Now they got to keep the pressure up and get this game equalized. As you see the replays, yep, just gets it in on the blocker side there on Varlamov, and it is 2-1. We got to keep going, though. Got to tie this game up. About 15 minutes left. Here's Niederreiter stick handling, and he's gonna center that one, and oh, he couldn't get good wood on that, as it looks like they may have had Varlamov beat, but it is not in the net. That's in the net there. The Avalanche. Whoa, hold up. They're waving it off. Was it a high stick? We're going to go to a replay here to see, and they're going to have to talk with Toronto here in the war room, and I don't know. Is that a high stick? Looks like it. This one might be taken away from Duchesne and the Avalanche. Yeah, it looks like it was above the bar, but we'll wait for the official call. It was called no goal right there, as you see, right in front of you. It's awesome to have all the refs on the ice in NHL 15, by the way. Yep, officially no goal. So the Wild dodge a bullet right there. You see Maxime Talbot taking a penalty late on in the third, and we've got a chance on the power play. Need to make it happen. Niederreiter's shot. No, that's handled cleanly by Varlamov. No rebound right there, and that's big. As the last seconds tick down, here's a big hit, and down the ice, a hard shot, but no. The shot by Vanek is turned away, and the Wild drop the opener to the Avalanche 2-1. It was a good game. It's unfortunate they had that ugly goal, that second goal, go in against them, because that was the difference. So we lose the opener to the Avalanche, and hey, we've got a home and home with them. So that's what's coming up next as we continue the Minnesota Wild Be a GM series here in NHL 15. I hope you'll join me. Going to try to take my hometown team deep into the playoffs this year. We'll see you next time, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.